Well, we didn't play very well tonight. Turned the ball over 17 times in the first half. Tough to win a basketball game. I thought Penn did a really good job of getting in passing lanes and speeding us up, and did a good job of attacking our pressure. But you know, there's no avenue to a win when you shoot 32% and turn the ball over 22 times. We have to be better. We're gonna get back to work, bury this one, and move on.
Is that an aspect where I guess Molly's lack of presence really shows? Kind of those pressure situations. You have a lot of young guards out there.
There is no doubt that Molly impacts our ability to handle those situations, but the talent on our roster is good enough to have been better tonight.
Did you have to switch your rotation more often than expected tonight based on how the Lakers were responding?
No, I think we flipped it the way we normally did. There was maybe one or two rotations that we were just playing so bad on the floor that we changed it faster. But there was nothing that they were doing that impacted how we were rotating our players. We certainly looked fatigued differently tonight than I've seen us all season. I have no explanation for it. We had a long Thanksgiving break. We had 3 good days of practice. It is what it was.
Anything you saw kind of when they kind of blitzed with that press there in the second quarter and really changed the game? Was that something you didn't expect, guys didn't expect? Or?
We did expect it. We've been practicing against the press, but I just think we got sped up and kind of disrupted on offense from it. Didn't handle it well.
I don't want to take anything away from Penn. He's the best coach in the city. He does an unbelievable job. Their team's really good and really talented. But if you watch tonight, it was not what they were doing. We were throwing the ball to players who weren't even getting after us. I can't explain it, but we panicked a little bit in a moment where we were trying to seize the day against a rival team, and we didn't handle that expectation very well. And that's kind of the theme for the season, to handle the expectations. We're supposed to do well, and you got to be able to handle it. Go back to the drawing board against Lehigh.
Do you have any updates on Molly?
Yeah, she's returned to activity, so when she's ready, she'll be out there. I don't have a time frame, but she's been on the court.
What do you think it was in the second half where after halftime the turnovers became fewer? I think it was there were like 17 turnovers in the first half and then 4 or 5 in the second. What was the adjustment made there?
Well, when you're down 21, there's no more pressure, right? There's no more expectation. You're probably supposed to lose, so go ahead and play free and get after it. That's my read. I don't know if they feel the same way, but we were much looser because what do you have to lose at that point?
Going into your next Big Five games, what do you guys think for what's down the line? I mean, this is your first one, so it's kind of a test a little bit.
I mean, honestly, I feel like we're just taking it one day at a time. Like, we just focus on each team the week of and the day of. We play them. I don't really look too far ahead. Just focus on the next team each, like just one day at a time.
Any other questions?
How do you go into a game? Simone Sawyer for them had kind of like lit it up the last two games. How do you kind of scout someone like that? And because she went off, she kind of did some different things tonight than she had done in the previous two games.
Yeah. Hell of a night for Simone. Can't deny that. She went to the basket hard. She made contested shots. We were ready for her. We knew what she did well. And, she out-executed us offensively to our defense. She was phenomenal tonight. And I believe it was, has she been starting the whole time?
This was her second start.
Yeah. She's got that starter confidence going.